Hi viewers, welcome to our electrical engineering lecture channel for most interactive sessions of different subjects of electronic and electrical engineering. For the latest updates and videos, don't forget to subscribe and click the like button.
Assalamu alaikum everyone, hope you are fine and safe. So today in the communication system 2 course we will be discussing the detection of multiple signals in Gaussian noise. Before proceeding towards the multiple signals, let us have a quick review about the binary signals in Gaussian noise, which we already covered. And we have seen that we can have two different types of detectors in case of the detection of signals in Gaussian noise. It is not specific to binary, but we will see later on that in case of multiple signals, we can also have these two types of detectors. But in case of binary, the problem is relatively simple, that it is a simple binary thresholding problem, that the received signal Z of t sampled at capital T, you have to just compare this Z of capital T with a specific threshold gamma. And if Z of T is greater than the threshold gamma, then the hypothesis H1 is true, which means the symbol S1 was transmitted and vice versa. And the two types of detectors were, the first one was maximum a posteriori detector or MAP detection, whose expression is given by this particular thing. And the maximum likelihood detector, the second one was maximum likelihood or ML detection, and it is a specific case of MAP detection when the priori probabilities are equal. In that case, this MAP detector will reduce to maximum likelihood detector. And by the way, maximum likelihood detector is the most widely used detector in digital communications. And we have also formulated the expression for probability of bit error, and we ended up with this expression, probability of bit error, in the form of Q function. You can see that it is related with three things. Number one is EB, which is the bit energy. The second one is correlation coefficient between S1 and S2, correlation coefficient. And number three is noise PST. So as a design purpose, the numerator is very much important, because the denominator is containing the noise PST, which is not in our control. So if you see that if rho is equal to 1 means the signals are fully correlated, then the argument of Q functions becomes 0. And we have already discussed that if the argument of Q function is smaller, probability of bit error will be large. They are inversely proportional. So if the argument of Q is 0, it means it will attain its maximum value, which is 0.5, which is the worst possible BER, or probability of bit error. On the other side, if rho is equal to minus 1, so the expression becomes Q of 2 EB over N naught square root. So it will definitely give a reduced bit error rate. So now we move on towards the detection of multiple signals in Gaussian noise. Overall, the things will remain almost the same, but now we have to consider n-dimensional PDFs. Because the signal is buried in noise, so the system model will become like this, that Si for any ith transmitted symbol, here I can be from 1, 2, 3 up to capital M, where M is the number of finite symbols, plus the noise N. So this is the received signal Z, this is the transmitted symbol, and plus this is the Gaussian noise. And in the discussion about signal basis functions, we have already seen that any signal can be represented in vector form through the use of orthogonal basis functions. So this signal vector Si can be represented by a vector form containing n coefficients, where n is the number of basis functions. So Ai1, Ai2, up to Ain. So it will contain these n constant numbers, this vector. And similarly, the elements of noise vector n, they will also be represented in the form of orthogonal basis functions. So it will have, it will be equal to N1, N2 up to N capital N. So these are basically IID, independent and identically distributed Gaussian random variables, and they have zero mean and variance of N0 by 2. So before moving towards the MAP detection and ML detection, because both these detectors, they are relying upon likelihood functions. And likelihood function is basically in the form of a PDF. It is actually a PDF. So we have to formulate the joint PDF expression. So to have this thing further in detail, let's write the PDF of the noise having zero mean and variance and not by 2. So PDF of noise sample, let's say N1. First of all, we will write it for N1 and then we will find the joint PDF. So let's say that is denoted by P of N1 and it will be equal to, because it is Gaussian, you can write it as 2 pi sigma square one by two e raised to power minus n1 square over 2 sigma square. So that is the expression for PDF. Now if you replace here sigma square equal to n0 by 2, because in our case the noise PSD is n0 by 2, so it will be rewritten as P of n1, it will be equal to 1 over pi n0, 2 will be cancelled out and it will be 1 by 2, let me write it like this, exponential minus n1 square divided by n0. So now, as all the noise samples are IID, which means joint PDF will be product of marginal PDFs. That is the basic rule, that if multiple random variables are independent of each other, then the joint PDF will be the product of their marginal PDFs. So let me write the joint PDF as equal to probability of n1 multiplied with PDF of n2, sorry, and up to PDF of n sub capital N. And if you multiply it, then by using, let me write it equation 1. So from 1, this joint PDF P of n bar, that will be equal to 1 over pi n naught. So as there are total of capital N number of random variables, so it will be pi n naught raised to power n by 2. And here it will be equal to minus n1 square plus n2 square plus up to n square divided by n0. So this particular thing, which is written in the numerator, so for a vector which was n is equal to n1, n2 up to nn, for this particular vector, this thing comes out to be norm of this vector. We have already discussed about the norms of the vectors, so you can here see like this. So let me rewrite the same thing as P of n, or the joint PDF of the noise vector, that will be equal to 1 over pi n naught raised to power n by 2 exponent minus n norm square divided by n naught. So we say it equation number 2. So this is the joint PDF of noise. Now having this joint PDF of noise in hand, now let us come again towards the slide. So in the similar way, we can also write the joint PDF of the received signal also. So if the received signal Z is given by this vector, again representing in the form of orthogonal basis functions, so it will be Z1, Z2 up to Zn. They are also independent Gaussian random variables, but as you all know that signal Z is basically the white noise plus deterministic signals SI. So by the theory of probability, you should know that whenever you add some deterministic signal in Gaussian random variable, its mean is shifted. So by using this theory, we can write the conditional PDF P of Z or P of the received data, PDF of the received data given SI, ith transmitted symbol. It will be denoted by this particular likelihood function, and it is the same as the above expression. It is also obtained by the product of the individual PDFs. So the difference only lies here that inside the exponential you have minus Z minus SI. So this particular thing is the mean. This particular thing is the mean. Likewise, you write in case of Gaussian random variable, e raised to power minus x minus mean whole square divided by 2 sigma square. So this particular thing is for mean. So here this SI is written in place of mean, and all other parameters remain the same. So this is the likelihood functions that is very, very important for the detection of signals. Now, first of all, we discuss the maximum a posteriori detector, which is MAP. So the basic rule for Bindi was that in Bindi we only had two likelihood functions, and we just took the ratio of those two likelihood functions. But here, and I've also told you that this detector is called maximum a posteriori detector because it uses or it compares the posteriori PDFs of the received symbols. So here we will be again comparing the posteriori PDFs. Posteriori PDFs means that the PDF found after the reception of signals and given the receive and data is received. So like if the received data, let me again just have a quick review of this a posteriori probability. A posteriori PDF. So if the received data is Z and the transmitted symbols is, let's say, SI, so PDF of SI given Z, that will be called a posteriori, right? So here we will be comparing the posteriori PDFs of all the possible symbols. So if we have a total of capital M symbols, then we will find and compare the posteriori PDFs of all these M symbols, and the symbol for which this a posteriori probability is the greater among all, that will be declared as the detected symbol. So set M is equal to MI, which means that the detected symbol will be MI if the probability of MI sent given Z, right? This is the posteriori probability. If this posteriori probability is greater than the posteriori probability of MK for all K not equal to I, which means that we will compare this posteriori probability with the posteriori probabilities of, with the posteriori probabilities of all the other symbols. And if that is greater, we will decide M hat is equal to MI. But this posteriori probability is not, we cannot find this a posteriori probability. The reason is that you have the expression as probability of the SI given the data is received. So we cannot fix the received data. We cannot find this conditional PDF. So we will apply Bayes' rule, Bayes' theorem, to convert this posteriori probability into an expression which can be found practically. So by finding, by applying the Bayes' law, if we come over here, let me use the same notation that we are using in the slide. So if the posteriori probability or PDF is SI given Z, by Bayes' rule, I can write this as probability of SI intersection Z divided by probability of Z. And by applying the theorem on conditional probability, I can rewrite the numerator as Z given SI into probability of Si divided by probability of C. So we have just represented the posteriori probability into this format by using Bayes' law. And you can see now this probability can be found because it is containing probability of Z